Let's go to the White House. It has a bank CEO, it says, is standing out from the pack in a good way. Juliana Goldman at the White House to tell us exactly who it is. Juliana.
Well, Carol, that bank CEO is Bank of America's Brian Moynihan, and administration officials say he stands out because he gets it. He gets that the industry has taken a hit in its reputation and that publicly fighting with the administration doesn't really do much to make it all that better. He also gets that regulatory reform is going to happen, and while there are some elements that he might not agree with, from a policy standpoint, he wants to be cooperative. He wants to be at the table to help shape that policy. Now, more broadly, the administration points to a few initiatives that Bank of America has pursued, namely when it comes to small business. Also, they have not criticized the Consumer Financial Protection Agency, as some other bank CEOs have. And they also talk about some quick modifications that they've made to their home lending program. But, Carol, overall, they say it's his tone, a much more cooperative tone that makes him stand out.
All right. So, Juliana, they like his tone, but you know he came in with some questioning on whether or not he was up to the task of being CEO. I mean, does the White House question that at all?
Not really, actually. They say he knows his stuff at a micro and a macro level. They say, really, he doesn't have the ego that some of the other CEOs have. They describe him as a roll-up-your-sleeves kind of person. And they point to one specific story when he was here at the at the Treasury behind me in January. He was at a dinner with Tim Geithner and some other bank CEOs. And throughout the dinner, some of those CEOs were griping about the populist tone here in Washington. They didn't like some of the administration's policies. And Moynihan actually stood up and said, hey, guys, we need to take some responsibility. We need to understand why there's this perception out here, and we need to band together to do something about it. And that really stood out to administration officials. But more broadly, from a business perspective, a lot of analysts say that this strategy, this tone of his, it's good for business. Right now, an embattled CEO, that's going to be reflecting in their stock price. So what's good for the administration is good for investors too, Carol. All right.